Heute bei Turok, Nils Neumann trifft Muse.
Salut, herzlich willkommen und moinsen allerseits bei einer Stunde Turok mit Muse. Gentlemen, pleasure to meet you.
Hey, how are you?
Very fine, and you?
Yeah, fine, thanks. Yeah, cool.
How's the year been for you?
Quick. It's gone very fast. We did, like, don't know, what did we do? Recorded an album, and then we went on tour, and now we're doing festivals, and now we're just about to go back on tour. So it's just gone very quickly.
Yeah. It's sad that when everything is going fine, that then everybody comes and wants to be your friend. Was that a topic for you? Have you been confronted with that?
Yeah, I've got lots of friends now, yeah. But I like it, yeah. Yeah, I mean, fake friends are the best friends.
Right.
Yeah.
No, not really. No, okay,
but for you guys, being unknown and then being in the media was like that.
Really? Yeah, it was.
I think
to us.
Tell me how it was to you.
From our point of view, it seemed like it was just very gradual. You know, like gradually crept in there. It didn't really seem like a sudden. Because we've been going for like nearly 7 years or something. And like I think really in the since the first album, the last 2-3 years, it's just gradually sort of, you know, the more gigs we play, the venues slowly become bigger and bigger and bigger, you know, so it doesn't seem like we've unnaturally jumped, you know.
Okay. Being now kind of famous and being known, is it like you imagined it to be when you were younger?
Yeah.
what's a good point on that?
Well, I mean, the main thing is you get to travel around so much, and so the best thing about traveling is you can do a gig, yeah, and get really drunk and embarrass yourself in front of lots of people you don't know, yeah, and then the next day, instead of waking up and being embarrassed, you're going to see them all in work or see them all. You can get up in a new place and there's a whole lot of new people to embarrass yourself in front of. So that's the best thing. Yeah.
And what's the worst thing? What disappointed you on all this showbiz and media and.
Festival bogs.
Oh, festival bogs.
What do you say? Festival bollocks. Yeah. What else? I don't know. Maybe, you know, it's all good, you know, but maybe lack of space or just maybe not having a base or time, a lot of time to sit around on your own. But I mean, we've been like busy solidly, but we've just like had 2 weeks off and we've just been sitting around our house watching TV, you know, so it's quite, you know, it's quite nice to be back out doing gigs again. So
nothing changed compared to being at school. Like Mark said that from JJ72, he said it's like meeting school friends, like being in school, having friends you meet all the time, like you.
Well, I don't know about Mark, but in school, I didn't really get that many girls, you know.
Jetzt kommen Sie erstmal live mit Muse im Museum.
Something to confess to, but you
Klassiker.
Das ist gerade Nada Surf mit Popular und davor Muse mit Muscle Museum, aber natürlich nicht live, sondern als Videoversion. Aber ich bin hier so aufgeregt, weil die Jungs hier sitzen, nicht?
Echt?
I said, we had the video for Muscle Museum on and not you guys live, because, but I, I'm so excited because you're sitting here.
Oh, really?
No.
Oh, damn, I wanted to believe you then.
When you're target of the media, of the press, there are always good things and bad things. Does that touch you? I mean, when they write...
You mean like bad reviews and good reviews? No, not really. I mean, because the thing is, like, everyone has their own opinion. You know, everyone's entitled to say what they want. You know, if I was a journalist, I'd just say what I want. So it's fair enough. You know, I mean, the thing is, a lot of the bad reviews, I can sometimes look at them and go, yeah.
Not like that you fear criticism. They say, oh, Origin of Symmetry is now. It's like the worst album.
I think if anything, like, I think I'm very critical upon myself anyway. You know, naturally. So, yeah. What about you? What was it?
Yeah, I don't know. I think, you know, it's good to provoke any sort of reaction as well, you know. I mean, obviously you get people that are really into it, but then you sometimes get reviews and when people sort of write about it badly, but they write about it badly in a good way, you know, and I think that's a good thing, to just, you know, read someone else's opinion about it, you know, someone who hates it.
Okay. Origin of Symmetry is out for a couple of weeks. What have you heard? Do the people think of it?
It seems to be good. I mean, what we see is from people doing gigs, and the new album's got some better riffs on it. You know what I mean? So like, I think it's better for the crowds and the venues and stuff. I think they feel a bit more like it's a bit more exciting. You know, some of the music. So I think some people say it's a bit more intense. I like that. Yeah.
I mean, the album, your debut album, Showbiz, was like mega successful. By the way, had you expected it to be successful? Like. We know what it takes to write a good rock album. We are pretty conscious of it all.
I don't know. I mean, you never know what's going to happen. I mean, I remember selling, like, we released a couple of EPs and we sold our first few hundred EPs when we were like 17, and that was like big success, you know. So I mean, I think you just anything like that, I think you just appreciate, you know, you appreciate what you can get, you know. I mean, if anything, it was a surprise. What surprised me was the success in other countries outside of UK. In a good way, it's a nice surprise, you know.
So, by doing Origin of Symmetry, did you feel like being under pressure to do another brilliant album, or was like let's do what we can?
No, we didn't really feel that pressured, I don't think. I think we toured for 18 months or so, and during that period, you know, we was like getting new songs together, like Plug In Baby and a few various other ideas. So when we actually took time away from touring and being very busy and actually got in a room with just the three of us, the new songs sort of happened quite quickly. So, and same, you know, same approach with the studio. We just had the songs, had like a list, and then just went straight in, and we talked about what songs we're going to do and talked about maybe how we're going to treat them. So it did sort of happen quite smoothly, really. And we just went in and got on with it and enjoyed it. So.
Dann gibt's jetzt erstmal was aus dem Album Origin of Symmetry, Plug In Baby. Und zurück hier mit Muse, das war gerade Tool, mit Skizzen. Tool, yeah.
We saw Tool the other night. Well, a while ago.
3 months ago.
Okay, 3 months ago, glad.
Like yesterday.
Really good. Really good, really good band.
They are. I heard that you said you listened to bands like Nirvana, Cream, Police, Hendrix, because from them you could learn how to fill gaps. From whom the most? I mean,
can you make it up?
Primus. I mentioned those bands is because they're three-piece bands mostly.
Yeah.
Right?
Yes.
Yeah, mostly three-piece. And any three-piece, it's like I think we've learned a lot from them because of the dynamic. Often you have to do the dynamic all together, you know, like everyone plays quietly together and everyone plays loudly together, so everyone's like together. Whereas in like a five-piece, sometimes the dynamic is just two people stop. Yeah, and then the other two people come in, and that's like the dynamic. So, I think who the most? I don't know. I'm not sure really. I'd say Jimi Hendrix Experience, maybe. No, Band of Gypsies or something like that. Or the Police, Nirvana. I'd say, I mean, all for different reasons, you know. I mean, Nirvana is just power, like raw power, you know, from a three-piece. And whereas I think Jimi Hendrix Experience was really dynamic, you know, like really. Well, no, it's just like a different sort of dynamic. Yeah. Anyway. Yeah, all of them.
What do you think? Is it easier for a three-piece band to work in the studio or to write songs, or is it difficult? More difficult?
What would you say?
I mean, you can't. I don't know if you can compare. Have you ever played with more guys?
Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't know. I mean, it seems sometimes in a three-piece, it's easier to be tempted to put lots of stuff on, maybe. So I wouldn't know. I think it is more difficult to get a three-piece to sound as good in a studio as it does live. You know, I think three-piece sounds for me the best live. But in a studio, it's sometimes very difficult to get that across. So it takes a lot of, you know, well, you just got to basically play as if it's a gig, you know.
There are four songs on the album, like Dark Shines, Bliss, Plug and Baby, and Newborn. For them, you've chosen David Bottrell as a producer. Why was that?
It was just, we just met him in a bar, you know. We didn't like specifically choose him. We met him, we knew that he'd done Deus, Ideal Crash, and he'd done some Tool stuff before. And we just met him in a bar somewhere in London, and we was chatting to him about music and what he's done, and thought, well, we wanted to just initially record Plugin Baby because we thought it might be a single. So we just went in there and sort of did Plugin Baby. That was the idea. And then we ended up doing a few more tracks like Newborn and Bliss and Darkshine. So, and then he went to do Tool, and then John Leckie came back and we met him. So then we continued with John Leckie.
How was that? I mean, when you told John Leckie for the very first time, okay, we got, for some songs, we got another producer. How was he reacting? Is he like jealous?
John Leckie?
Yeah.
He's just
like, okay. Nah, the main reason,
did you say about John Leckie in Africa and all that?
I said he was away.
The main reason was John Leckie was already busy. He was working in Africa or whatever, so he couldn't do it anyway. So we were just looking at other people. Dave Bottrell came along, and then Dave Bottrell, we only did a few songs because we only got to do it as a trial, you know, just to do one song. We ended up doing four songs in a couple of weeks, and then he had to go and work with the Tool album. So he disappeared for the rest of about 4 months. So, and then John Leckie came back. You know, John Leckie came back into. So it's just like a bit of coincidence, really. Yeah.
Okay, it was cool for him.
Was er?
It was cool
it was,
for him.
Yeah, it was, yeah.
Dann gucken wir uns jetzt mal noch was an, was der David Bottrell gemacht hat. Hier kommt Newborn. Und das gerade Weezer mit Hashpipe. Fantastisches Lied. So, still talking about Origin of Symmetry. I mean, listening to the record, it's still Muse sound. But what would you say for yourself? And where have you grown? And what points have you become better? I mean, dynamically?
From the first album.
Yeah.
Live stuff. I think because we've been playing live so much, we've just become better and tighter, and I think we've just got that across on the album a lot more than we did on the first one.
Making it sound a bit more like a three-piece band. So I think on the first album it could sound like more than a three-piece sometimes. And also the integration of piano and keyboard stuff without it being like an extra thing. Like for a song like Space Dementia, it is just piano, bass and drums, just three-piece. But it's still quite heavy rock, you know? And the thing is, a lot of... You look at someone like Ben Folds 5, who uses piano. I really like that, you know, but I wanted to find a way of using piano in us that sounded like Muse, you know, like piano, heavy rock. So I'd say that's probably, for me, like a sign of something that's definitely different to anything we've done before. You
know? When I listen to the record, it's like, it seems to me like you empty out your soul. I mean, especially you. I mean, it's all of you guys, but at Matthew, I can fix that picture. I mean, is that just a tool you know how to use, or is it pure passion?
It's pure passion. No, it's like, I mean, yeah. I mean, what can I say? I mean,
is it like that you sit together and know, okay, to make it sound like this, we have to...
I mean, the process of pushing yourself vocally and emotionally to those levels, you can't create that sort of sound without feeling that, you know, you just can't. You can't fake it, and so there you go.
what's essential for music that you like it? Know what I mean? Fuck.
My English is sometimes.
I think for me at the moment, I mean. What's essential? What's essential in music? The thing is, like, I don't know. Dom, help.
What's essential? You know, the whole thing, enjoyment. Fucking. You don't do music if you're pissed off. yeah.
What's essential?
What's essential is?
Well, what essentially is for me, the avoidance of too much computer enhancement. Like the not having too much computer generated sounds. Right. I think to be honest, all the music I listen to is of a non-computer generated nature.
Okay.
Just for some reason, it brings me more pleasure. No. Yeah. Apart from dance music, but I mean that's a different thing, you know. So, but I mean, in terms of stuff I listen to at home, it seems to be all like that. Yeah.
Your request videos are coming up. Und noch ein letztes Mal herzlich zurück hier mit Muse.
Bully's lost a bit of weight.
So,
forget it, sorry. I saw someone who looked like someone we knew, that's all.
Oh, yeah, alright. Who?
That guy there.
The guy. Andreas Dermann, von der Virgin.
he looks like an old guitar tech.
Okay.
But he's much thinner.
What comes up next for you guys? I mean, another virtual, like you did with the Showbiz tour? Like, playing.
Just gigging, yeah. I mean, just gig all the time. Basically, we're doing festivals, and then we've got another big European tour at the end of the year. And then when that's finished, that's it. We're going to America for about 6 months, or something. Maybe longer.
Long.
Yeah, yeah. And
have you ever played there in America?
Yeah, we did one small tour, only down the middle. We haven't really played properly in the main East Coast and West Coast. We did a tour with Red Hot Chili Peppers and Foo Fighters down we played with them.
Yeah.
It's strange.
It's ridiculous. Yeah. We're like opening up for them. That was quite scary. But that was the last time we went there. So that was about nearly 2 years ago, or a year and a half ago. So we haven't been there for a long time.
At the moment, I think you are learning the piano. I mean, you can play the piano, but you want to get better and better and better. So maybe that now on the album Origin of Symmetry, there are two songs or three songs without guitars, just bass, piano and drums. So maybe for the third album, and any plans to change your sound, maybe do more electronical stuff?
I don't know. I'm sort of like... I don't think sometimes you never really know what might happen until you get in the studio. I mean, in terms of writing the songs and making the songs, I think it'll probably be similar to what we are live, you know, always. But then, like, when you get in the studio, sometimes it'll turn out completely different. Yeah. So, okay. Yeah, but I won't know that. We probably won't be recording until the middle of next year.
So we'll see what comes. Then.
Yeah. Right.
Pleasure to have you here, guys. Thank you very much. That's it. Das war's mit Turok für heute und für überhaupt. Und jetzt kommt Muse nochmal live.